Letter to United Nations Secretary General, June 23, 2020 by Anna von Reitz. Dear Secretary General Guterres, as the legitimate and now only government still standing, the United States of America, Unincorporated, requests to see those Geneva Conventions and G-5, G-7, and G-20 treaties that the United States DBA United States, Inc., and the United States of America DBA the United States of America, Inc., have signed in our names, so that we may determine whether or not any of our contracts with these entities and the principles involved were authorized. The exact terms and nature of our contracts with these other principles are well known throughout the world as the Constitution of the United States and as the Constitution of the United States of America. It is also generally known that we have not altered nor amended those service contracts since 1819 and that our government has not been called into session since 1860. It is self-evident that our trust both in the other principals and in our employees has been misplaced and that a great deal of embezzlement, fraud of various kinds, usurpation against the lawful government, and international breach of trust has taken place. We think it only right and proper that we request to be brought up to date regarding these corporate bankruptcies via treaty which have been taking place in our names without any granted authority from us, and that we should be held harmless, and that our guarantees and property interests should be honored not only by the other principals who are responsible for this grotesque injustice, but by all other governments worldwide. If it is within the power and knowledge of your office or your members' offices, please forward copies of the current treaties and record our exemption and objection to being presumed upon. Please also note that the Carter administration had no authority to transfer any of our state offices to the United Nations. The International Organizations Immunity Act of 1976 is a nullity in that respect. Finally, please note that the Carter administration had no authority to transfer illegally purloined child labor contracts and bonds established under false presumptions upon Americans to the IMF, and the IMF, equally, had no authority to sell or transfer those bonds to BlackRock, Inc. and its assigns. The fundamental international maxim of law that applies is, possession by pirates does not change ownership. The further fundamental international maxim of law that pertains is, fraud vitiates all. We, the American states and people, have been grossly defrauded in breach of trust. We have borne the lion's share of the world's debts and expenses. We have paid the bulk of the cost of rebuilding the entire world infrastructure since the end of World War II, and we have been repaid with nothing but disservice by our own misdirected employees and our purported allies. Let this be a lesson and stand as an example before all the other national governments of the world of exactly how coercive, unaccountable, and criminal incorporated entities by nature are, and the foolishness of allowing any incorporated entity to operate as a government, and equally, the foolishness of principals who abandon their contractual obligations to incorporated entities. It is not, we repeat, not our intention nor our desire to create panic, nor is there any reason for panic. There is, however, need for sober reconsideration of the rights and responsibilities of the various nations involved and also a need for negotiated settlement of the issues. Most sincerely, Anna Maria Riesinger, Fiduciary the United States of America, Unincorporated.